I guess so. We can totally do that. Or I can read something that's about my insatiable love for, like, you know, passion and shit. It's totally up to you guys. This is the interactive portion. Okay. Alrighty. Well, you said the one that I didn't know where it was, so. Okay. It's almost there. I know, huh? This is embarrassing. This is like 20 pages and stuff. It's called The Sweet Left Arm, the one closest to my heart. I'm missing four bones in my ear to do with invisibility and apparently levitation. That's what my doctors are saying. That's why I walked the extra mile to see you. I could have taken the bus, you see, but something about it seemed cheap. Like I wasn't working hard enough for your graces. And you said, don't worry about it. I wouldn't ask you to do anything like that, you said. At midnight, the sprinklers at the park went off. And we packed our gear back into the van and drove back home. The easiest way to do it, though, is for me to come up to you and hold your head while I'm telling you this. Second easiest way is for me to just fuck your brains out. It is inspiring to have, you know. Are you sure you don't want to hear the Jesus poem?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, Jerusalem on donkey.
Almost. Yeah, I kind of feel like I have to do that. Normally I would be like, you know, obsessive compulsive and show you like awesome guitar scales, but it just sounds like it is fun. This is called To Nazareth by Donkey.
Yeah.
It's a story in three parts. First part is called The Oldest Pub in Mesopotamia. I found Jesus sitting in the darkest corner of the pub, sipping on a drink. I'll have what he's having, I said. The bartender passed me my drink, and I sat down next to Jesus. You're Jesus of Nazareth, aren't you? I asked. You mustn't tell anyone you saw me here. I'm in trouble with the Samaritan, he replied. Samaritan? What did you do? He sniffed. I might have danced with some lepers.
Oh!
He brushed his hair back wistfully. I guess they just didn't want my help. I had to feel bad for him, being the Messiah and all. But what could I say but, shit, Jesus, this is a strange group. Chapter 2. Jesus introduced me to Peter, and we set out for Nazareth on a tiny donkey. Peter was black and lived on Crenshaw, near 42nd, where he owned a liquor store. You ever clip a donkey's toenails? He asked me after we had traipsed back to the pub to fetch Jesus' sunglasses. Donkeys don't have toenails, I told him. He wore a stocking on his head to cover his bald spot. He wasn't such a bad guy or anything, but his questions were a pain in the ass. Shut up, man, Jesus said. everybody is a black. Chapter 3. We have just about given up the ghost when a fabulous Jewish princess offered herself for 2 gold pieces. Jesus stepped back a bit, arms across his chest. I've known many women like you. She spat on the ground and left Jesus smirking quietly before us. After a time, he asked us if we thought she was cute. Peter didn't think so, but I was horny as hell. Shit, Jesus, she's all right, I said. Jesus gave a sly grin and said, quick, who's got 2 gold pieces? We can still catch up with her. Boy, was Peter pissed. He cursed Jesus several filthy times until he finally rebuked him with a swift bolt of lightning to the crotch. Peter howled in pain and lit off on our ass. He must have been hurting something bad. So Jesus told him to turn the other cheek. He loved helping people. That was the truth.